Now, what's better than gluten-free waffles than naturally gluten-free maple syrup? Every year, as a hobby, we tap the maple trees. Then we collect the sap and then boil it down into this maple syrup. It's so much work, but so good. It's like liquid gold. If you buy it in the store, you don't quite appreciate what it takes to get this stuff. When the winter drags on, this is the perfect family activity. So if you are interested in doing this yourself, I'll go through some of the details. Over the last 5 years, we've figured out a lot of little tips. The process isn't difficult, but it will get you in the great outdoors. It really doesn't take a lot of equipment. Spackle buckets, tubes, even use some old plumbing parts. Anything will work. Now, we have found that you want to have the buckets covered because you don't want rainwater in there. They do sell special tubing and fittings that can go into the trees. This is the modern way to do it, and you drill a much smaller hole than you used to. We do both. We use the new method and we use the old method, or at least a version of the old method. When you drill the holes, you want it tilted slightly down so the sap runs out of the hole. We also put red paint on the tip of the bit so we know how far to drill in. We drill in about 1.5 inches. So you want to tap these trees when the temperature hits 50 degrees. When the temperature goes from 30 degrees to 50 degrees, that's when the sap is running. If you want to get more sap out of the tree, know where the sun is hitting and warming up the bark. We ran an experiment this year. We put one bucket on the warm side of the tree and another one on the cold side of the tree. After measuring the results, it was more than 50% more sap on the warm side of the tree. I've always heard this, but I wanted to try it for myself. When we collect the sap, we usually fill the buckets about halfway because we have a big hill we have to walk down. Let me tell you, you take it slow down this hill because I've dumped a couple buckets. You don't want to dump buckets because it takes 40 gallons of sap to make 1 gallon of syrup. We're currently tapping about 7 trees, so that gives us about 1.5 gallons of maple syrup. What you see in these buckets is about 2 weeks worth, but the volume depends upon the temperature changes. You do want to keep this sap cold because it can go rancid. Some people say you can take the ice and pitch it out because it doesn't have much sugar, and that is true, but it does have some sugar, so we boil it all down. I've seen people take the ice, boil it down, and there absolutely is sugar. So now with a nice hot fire, we can get started. We boil everything down in an old wringer washer stainless steel tub. We welded a plate in the bottom to seal it off. Then we build a structure with brick to hold everything together. In the fall, we use this to make apple butter. In order for us to keep the smoky flavor out, we made this aluminum ring. It's like an extended chimney. You can see the steam coming out the top, and the smoke stays out. The extended chimney just pulls right off, but it did a terrific job of keeping that smoky flavor out. Now, if you don't mind the smoky flavor, you don't need this thing. I personally don't mind the smoky flavor, but I know a lot of people that do. When there's lots of liquid in there, you can keep the temperature as high as you want it, but once it starts to get low, you do not want to burn the syrup, so you want to pull the fire way down. At this point, you watch it like a hawk. We pour it from the big pan, we filter it once in a coarse screen, then we filter it through a coffee filter. And now, you've seen basically the whole process. And it is a lot of work, but it's so worth it. I hope you enjoyed checking out the process, and thanks for watching.